Oh dear. Right. Okay. Oops. Okay, so here's a really good tip. If you're going to go live, actually click the go live button. I think I've just done 20 minutes to myself.
That's okay, you have an audience. Hello. It's just us. It's just very, very small.
Unbelievable.
Hello, everyone.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the live stream. Oh, dearie me. Right, okay, so from the top, can you do me a huge favour? If you can actually see and hear this, if this is actually coming through, can you let us know? If you saw the last 10 minutes, can you also let me know? I don't think anyone did. Unless something really random happened. I don't think anyone saw them. They were brilliant though, weren't they? That was the best bit of 10 minutes I've ever done. Right, okay. So, for those that don't know me, let me introduce myself. Hello! My name's Gavin Hoey. I was gonna say I'm a professional photographer, but I'm certainly not a professional YouTuber after that performance. And I'm not on my own. I've been joined, and this is the bit that's really going to be brilliant. I've got two assistants behind the camera who totally didn't notice that we weren't live.
No, actually, yeah, we did eventually notice, yeah.
No, no one's actually commenting on anything.
So hi, everyone.
Hello.
Yeah, we can see where you're all from, because loads of you were sitting there waiting. I hope you had a cup of tea or coffee to keep you company till we eventually joined you. But we've got Vienna, France, Chatham, Greece, Stenning, which is just down the road, Bournemouth, North Wales, Stockholm, Netherlands, Denmark, South Africa, New York, and lots in Italy.
Yeah.
So loads of people here. Thanks for sticking with us, guys. And we're off.
I think everybody has to do that. If they do YouTube Live or anything live, I think there always has to be a time when you forget to click the Go Live button. I'm pretty sure I'm not the first YouTuber to have done that. Maybe I am. Maybe that's unique. Right, okay, so we're 10 minutes behind, so thank you very much if you waited, well done. If you left earlier, then hey, never mind, you know, who knows what you've missed. So what am I going to be doing today? So today, I'm going to be playing with fire. That's the idea, but I'm going to be playing with fire in a very safe way. You'll find out why. This is going to be quite a safe and sensible thing. Now, of course, what I actually need to go is find all the pictures I was talking about earlier, which I now don't have. Bear with me. Yeah, okay. Sam, hop over to my laptop a minute. Okay, there we go. So this is what I'm going to do. Yeah, it's coming. Don't give it a second. There we go. That's the least of my technical problems. So this is where we're going to end up. I want to set fire to thin air and have it sort of hovering just in front of my face. And I wanted to make it feel like it was sort of a nighttime kind of feel. This was my test shot yesterday. So the way it works, whenever I'm doing a video, I don't just sort of start recording and off we go. There is some actual planning involved, which is astonishing when you actually watch the videos because they are actually planned. So I normally start with me as the model. That's not true. I'll show you actually what I start with in a second, but I'll run through the whole shoot with me first before I actually get the models in. And that way you get an idea whether it's going to work, whether it's going to look good. I've got to beat that photo. That's the plan anyway. Okay, so Sam, before I go on for another 10 minutes, can anybody hear us?
Yes, there's loads of people here. We've got Kuwait, another from Italy, hello. Germany, Iceland, Slovenia.
So it's
great. And thanks for sticking with us, everyone. Really appreciate it. Thank you.
Oh, that's hot. I've got hot tea.
What, tea? That's hot? Goodness me.
My Pixar Pro mug. Very efficient. Oh boy, that went right on my nose. Okay, good. Okay, so I'm not talking to myself, so this is good news. Okay, so we're going to crack on. So my assistant for this, I've got two assistants. I can't remember if I've said it in this one or the last one, so I'm going to say it again anyway. Behind the camera, we've got Sam. You've already heard from Sam.
Hi.
And also my daughter Freya is here helping as well.
She doesn't have a mic.
No, I don't have a mic.
No, she doesn't have a microphone. She is technical support, IT support for a large company.
Unnamed large company.
Never mind. Anyway, right, okay. So this is the fourth member of the team. This is my little mannequin head that we use to practice on. This is my practice head. And Sam came up with a fantastic name, because apparently you have to name these things. And she's called?
She's called Polly. And Polly's a part of the team. She's a very quiet part of the team, but she's very efficient and always there when you need her. And she never complains if the studio's really cold or really smoky or really hot. So she's great.
Yeah, she is. She's very, very useful. It is an incredibly useful thing to have. So when you're fiddling around with lighting, trying to come up with lighting ideas, having something like this to work with is absolutely brilliant, because you can try different lighting setups. And if you're only shooting head and shoulders like I do here in my small home studio, this works really well. It's got a hat, because otherwise the light just kind of feels a bit weird. So she normally ends up wearing a baseball cap. So that's the theory. We're going to use Polly to sort of set all the lights up, work out the lighting. Then I will go in her place, stand here and take the picture with the imaginary fire. And then after that, we're actually going to make some real fire and then photograph that. Okay, so I'm going to break this down into pieces, pretend fire, real fire, Photoshop the two together. That's the plan. So let's get going with the lighting. Now, I could do this in all sorts of different ways, but you get an advanced look, so I don't have to do the beginning bit. Which camera is it? This one, here we go. So this is the light I shall be using today, which is a Pixapro Pika 200. It won't focus quite on it, but eventually it will. There we go, Pika 200. Wrapped around the end is a gel held in place by rubber bands, because that's what you do when you're working in a studio. And this is going to be fire. I've got this as an orange color because I want it to look like fire with that bright orangey color. Now, I've got it in a small snoot, which is the little shiny silver thing that you could see there. And the reason for that is I don't really need a big burst of light. I just need a small point source of light. And this was the smallest thing I could find that kind of fitted onto the end of the Pika 200. I think it's an actual snoot. There was a black bit that fell off years ago that was supposed to be on there. But it might also just be the bulb cover. It could also just be a toilet roll. I mean, the inside of a toilet roll would probably fit about perfectly into there. So that's the plan. So I'm going to put it here so it's nice and close to where my head's going to be. And you've got to imagine there is a ball of fire here. And if there was a ball of fire, it would project light in a circle around here. The light would be a nice orangey color. That's the plan, okay? That makes sense? Are we okay? Hopefully. It'll make sense as we go along, trust me. It's one of those things that will make more sense as we take the photos. My first photo is always the same thing. My first photo is a picture without flash. So I'm working at my flash sync speed, 250th of a second. I'm at F4, and I'm also at 200 ISO, native ISO. And I'm trying to get more or less no flash, no picture. There is a little bit of the picture coming through for the simple reason that, she's white. She's completely, made of polystyrene. I've got a little bit more of a tan than she has. So hopefully I'm not quite that pale and pasty, although being stuck in here for 3 months, maybe I am. So that's the plan. I think that's going to be okay. Right, let's take an actual picture with flash. Quick tip, make sure that your flash is turned on. It is. Check which group it's in. It's in group A. Group A on my remote control. And let's start, we could do a meter, but I'm just going to do trial and error. And I'm going to start at 1/32nd power. Ooh, that's kind of bright. Okay, so that's a bit brighter than I intended. I don't think I need it quite that bright. I'm trying to work out where it is. There, somewhere over there. You get it. It's a bit bright here, there. So I can turn the power down. Let's do that. Let's go down. This one goes down to 1/128th power. And that's going to be, okay, that's better. But you wouldn't even think there's a gel on it looking at that. I mean, I've got a little screen over here, so I'm going to come a little, nothing. So even on its lowest possible power, it's slightly burning out the gel color. There may just be a hint. If I go in a bit closer, it may just be a hint of warmth. Not really. I was expecting more, to be honest, but never mind. So I've got a plan B. Always have a plan B. Plan B is going to be, if I can work out which camera it is, another gel. So I've got another gel I'm going to stick on the top. This one is called, oh, it's really small print. Why do they make it so small? Oklahoma Yellow. It's a yellow. I picked up a yellow. I thought if this went wrong, I'd add another gel. And this is the one I came up with. So I'm going to add that in using elastic bands. Yeah. Real mess to get this on. So if you're just joining us, well done. Thank you for finding us. Really appreciate it. If you've got any questions as this is going on, this is a live session, feel free to stick the questions in. Sam and Freya, the other side of the camera monitoring the chat. Have we got any questions yet?
No, I think we're all right.
We're all good? It? Okay. Are there real people here this time?
There are. Yes. So, yes, if you missed earlier, we were streaming to nobody because we didn't go live. But we're live now, so. Oh, no, we have a question.
We have a question.
So we have a new system where we can pop it on the screen. So Bob's asked, where do you get the magician's flash paper from? So, I mean, I can answer that.
Yeah, you can answer that. Yeah. When did we mention that? Did we mention that? Oh, we did in the comments, in the information.
In the information, So Bob and everyone else listening, we use flash paper, which we got from a magician shop. So we bought them online. I don't know any magic shops that are actually physical places. I don't think I've ever been to one.
No, I bet there's some in New York.
I bet there are, yeah. So just ordered online. And there's several different types. There's several different, there's like string,
there's
cotton wool.
Pop my laptop on, that's where you're talking. Thank you.
So there's several different types and we've got a sort of sparkly type, which you'll see later.
Yeah, we'll get to that in a minute. The fun bit is when we get to set fire to things. So I'm quite looking forward to that. I think that's probably okay. They're about the same height as me. Okay. And we'll just see. There we go. So I've added the extra yellow gel, and the idea with that one is it should just throw a bit more of a yellowy colour in there. It's not quite as fiery as I would like, but I think that's going to be okay because it's not the only colour I'm going to add in because, well, you can't really see. She's disappearing into the background. So if we say that light's okay, it possibly wants to come up a little higher, doesn't it? Because the fire would be up here. Yeah, let's try that. Let's go up slightly higher. Yeah, that looks pretty good.
I have a question.
Yeah, far away.
Would having a reflector with the orange gel in front of the head work?
Yeah, it would. It would give you a larger source of light. Now, what I am going to have to do is clone some of this out because I'm going to have to put a whole ball of fire there. But I'm not too worried about that. But the smaller it is, the less there is to clone. I'm also going to add some smoke into the scene. At least that's the plan. So I think this works quite well. But yes, of course, you could do it with a standard reflector. Get a different result. Having the gel just slightly sticking off the front has just helped to give it that slightly sort of wraparound effect rather than it being a complete direction if it was just a bare reflector or snoot. So that worked quite well. I'm happy with that. Good question. Okay, so that's okay. Now what I want to do is add in a light over here. So I'm going to try and do that with a second light. And today's second light is... Let's have a little look.
Someone's actually said the magic shop at Diagon Alley.
Of course. So,
it's actually not that far away from us where they filmed it, is it?
No, Pinewood.
No, that was actually in...
Diagon Alley up in London.
Yeah, I can't remember what it's called, yes. But beautiful, beautiful building, a shopping centre.
Yeah, I think they used it as the influence, not sure they filmed it. Maybe they did film it there. Anyway, today's little light of choice as my background light is... Which camera is it? That one. This one, which is a flashpoint from Adorama Explore 300. I've got to say, actually, the Explore 300 is rapidly becoming my favourite flash. I'm really liking this one. I've also got it in a small Pixapro softbox. The more important thing is the grid. I just need a bit of direction from this. So I'm going to add that in. I'm going to turn it on. Here we go. And this is going to be my separation light. So I'd like this one to come in from behind and put a little wash of colour just back here. Now, what you can't see, because it's sort of deep inside and I don't really want to take it apart, is a blue gel. So I've stuck a blue gel onto the front of the light, just to make sure that this has a nice bluish feel to it. We could do this by trial and error. Let's actually do it properly this time. That's on B, so I'm going to meter this through and I'm going to put it on, let's go for 1/8 power. Let's see how that goes. Okay, that's F2.5. Ooh, only F2.5. Oh, crikey. F3.6. I'm shooting at F4, so I need that to be to F4, which it does. Okay. So, let's have a little look. Okay.
So, we have another question.
Oh, can you put the laptop on?
Oh, sorry.
That's all right. There you go. Far away with the question as well.
Okay. As you're working multiple shots, could you not change the white balance to achieve your desired colour if you don't have gels?
Yes. Okay. That's a really good thing. You could. You could indeed do that. So we could make this white light and then dial in the camera to be a really blue white balance. And then, but then this would be blue as well. So you could. But that doesn't quite work. So you need at least one gel on something, otherwise you'll just make everything go blue or everything go warm. So you could, and I am actually shooting on slightly cold white balance. I think I'm about 4000K, so I am slightly colder than standard anyway, but you're gonna need at least one gel to get the difference in color, if that's what you want to achieve. Of course, there's no right and no wrong. You could have blue fire, yeah, why not? Okay, so that's okay, but not sure about this sort of area up here, which I'll show you on this area up here, where it's just catching the background a little bit. I think what I'd like to do is just feather the light away from the background, which is why I've got the grid. Take the same shot again, and hopefully this time, that should make that background go much darker. It does, that's pretty good. Although it's metered F4 and correctly metered, I think from personal taste, I'm going to drop that exposure down, maybe a stop on the back of our model's head, just so it's not quite so intense. Because it doesn't need to be the true exposure, that's a starting point. Exposures are always personal things, so the correct exposure is whatever you say it is. So if you want something dark and moody, that's correct. In this case, I think that just feels a little bit better like that. Okay, so that's that bit done. That's the basic lighting. I need to do some smoke. Now, I forgot to plug the smoke machine in and it takes 4 minutes to warm it up. So if you've got any questions, now would be a really good time to get them in. Let's pop that into there. And we'll see what we've got. Okay, I'm happy with that. Right, so checking everything is sort of in focus. The focusing is working okay. This we're gonna need to clone out. I'm happy with that. I'm prepared to do that. So. We're all good.
So someone's just asked, Richard just asked, just discovered you were live. Any chance of some warning about these sessions when they're going to appear?
yes and no. Richard, I can give you an advance warning. Friday this week at 2 o'clock London time, we will be live again on Olympus UK's Facebook page. Okay, so it's completely free. These are all free. They're not free for us. They cost us money, but they're free for you. So please go check that out. And in future, we will do more of these. Instagram. Go find my Instagram stories. We announced this 24 hours ago, more or less. And there was actually a link rolling on the page as well for 24 hours. So whether or not that actually worked, I've no idea. But yeah, Instagram is probably the place to go find out on my IG stories. All right, okay, how are we doing? We're up to red. I'll bring
my have another question. Do you have pets? Which Freya was very keen to answer.
Do we have pets? I don't think Freya counts as a pet. Is that what you're saying?
No. Freya is our daughter. She's here with us today, helping. Yeah, we do have pets. We have a cat, a very fluffy cat called Jake, who isn't in here today. And we also have two chickens called Conker and Belle.
There you go. And other useless facts are available. Okay, so we're up to speed. There you go. So this is my little smoke machine. This is the Hurricane 1200 from Chevet. I like it for a couple of reasons, mostly because when you forget to plug it in, it warms up really quickly and we're good to go. But mostly because I can control the output really, really well using the remote control. In here is a special effects smoke. It's often known as fast dissipating or CO2 effect because it looks really cloudy and then disappears. Otherwise, once I start this, you wouldn't see anything for the rest of the video. Okay, so let's get this going. Let's get some smoke into the scene. And we'll put a little bit of smoke in here. So at the moment, I've just got it on its lowest output, just so it can trickle along and just slowly trickle out smoke. We'll give it a nice little helping hand up. Okay. I'll tell you what I haven't tried, the overhead camera. Let's see that one. Oh, were you? I should look at the output every now and again. Okay, here we go. Oh, I can't wait, I'm impatient. There you go. That's more like it. Okay, so. No problem, that looks okay. Let's do one more as the smoke's coming through. Okay. So the smoke kind of works. You can see the smoke's coming in. And if I go back one, smoke is all the way across the scene, but it's really only appearing on the right-hand side. And the reason for that is a little bit there, actually. It's not so bad there. But the main reason for that is I haven't really got any light on the left-hand side. There's nothing on here to light the smoke. And you have to backlight smoke in order to see it. So let's add a third light into the scene. I've got one, I might as well use it. Let's go grab it, show you what it looks like. Okay.
So I have a few questions.
Far away.
What's the camera tripod you're using?
The camera tripod is a Benro, which I believe is discontinued now, but it is a Benro something, 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 something. FPC, I can't, why did they put dark blue writing on a black background? I mean, when you get old, challenge. That's really hard to see.
And also, AD200 or AD200 Pro, what's the difference?
I can't read it, it's rubbed off. AD200 or AD, well, that's a good question, actually. That nicely sets us up for this question. Which camera, this camera? This is, Sam, can you go to the other camera? Go to the number one. That's it, that one. Okay, it focuses closer. This is the AD200 Pro. This is actually the Adorama Flashpoint version, the Evolve 200 Pro, or the Pika 200 Pro from Pixar Pro. The difference is it's a bit flatter at the back. That's pretty much the main difference, actually. It goes down to 256th power rather than 128th, so you get one stop less light, which sounds like a negative. It's really handy, that. Really, really useful. Other than that, they're kind of interchangeable. I couldn't really say get one over the other. I'd probably go for the non-pro, if I'm honest. It's one of the few of that, the Godox range of lights where the non-pro version is meh, where the pro versions are normally really considerably better. This one, meh. Okay, so this is on C, so it's on its own separate group. Same channel, different group. Let's bring the light in something like that. So that is going to push light and fill up this end of the scene. That's the idea. Let's get some smoke going.
I have a question about the smoke as well.
Yeah, far away.
Does a smoke machine produce better smoke than smoke from a can?
Yes, most definitely. Good question. So yes, it does. Smoke from a smoke machine. Oh, got to turn it on. Oh, it is on. Hang on. Smoke from a smoke machine does. It's thicker for a start. Oh, I see what I've done. It's thicker. It tends to be more longer lasting. You can choose different types of density of smoke. So there's a whole bunch of different reasons for using a smoke machine rather than smoke from a can. It's a heck of a lot cheaper in the long run as well. So a can of smoke will set you back £10 or so, even more sometimes, where this smoke machine cost me about £80. And after that, you just buy smoke. Apparently I'm not in the shot. That's right. No one wants to see me anyway. I'm fine. Okay. Just pop it over to my laptop so we can see what's coming in. So you can see how the smoke is now being lit on the left-hand side. as well as on the right-hand side. So we have two sides of smoke being lit. But you also notice how it's completely random. It's very, very difficult to control smoke. Now, this is fast dissipating, so it disappears really quickly. But even so, I've got to put a little bit of effort in here because I don't want any smoke in front of where I'm going to be. I want the smoke to really be between the lights in the background and the back of my head. That would be the ideal position. Let's just move it around a little bit, waft it about. That's why I like using fast dissipating smoke in a studio, because you can make it disappear really quickly, reposition the smoke, and start getting something interesting. Okay, so we're getting there. That's good at getting there. I'm kind of happy with that. It is just catching the side of her head a little bit with this light. So I'm going to angle that away from our subject. Yeah, there's a little blue bit on her cheek, but I'm kind of going to live with that, I think.
Just wanted to say that that's not going to be our model for the entire shoot, if anyone's just joined us.
Oh yes, if you're just joining us, this is the stand-in me.
Yeah, Gavin's actually going to take the place of Polly, who is our polystyrene head, just in case you've just joined us.
Okay. Happy with that. Okay, so at that point, I think I probably should stand in. Let's get rid of this. And let's just come and stand in here. So the plan is I will be sort of here, and I can't help but think she's taller than me. Everybody's taller than me. So let's try that. Now, I can't just stand there. I've got to do a couple of things. The first thing is I need a self timer, so I've got time to run in and get myself in the right place. And my Olympus has a 2 second or a 12 second self timer. Now, I'm optimistic, but you know, 2 seconds is pushing it. Next, I want to make sure I focus on where I'm going to be. So F4 would be the equivalent of F5.6, F8 on a full frame. So I get a fair bit of depth of field. I've got a little bit of wiggle room. I'm also going to flip the screen round so I can see where I'm going to be. Oh, put the smoke machine on. Oh, this is going to go off before I get there. 12 seconds. Perfect, you see? Look at that. I managed to get everything in. Not much smoke, but it's kind of working. Yeah, that looks okay. I'm going to come down here. Yeah, I must look less happy. I think that's a definite thing. Let's just push that way a little bit. And let's try again. Okay. Oh, all the smoke's going exactly where I said don't go. Okay, so I'm going to be holding fire. It's going to be in my hands. Oh, blimey, I shouldn't look at the flash. Oh, this is why you pay models, because they know not to do daft things like that. That'll go down another stop. Let's take that down another stop. Okay, cool. Okay, so, yay, that looked all right, didn't it? That one worked. That's what we're after, just not that person in it. So, let's switch this off, and this is the bit I didn't want to do. Okay. So I raided the costume department, also known as Freya's temporary office, because she's working at home and she's working out of our prop store / makeup room, which we can't use anyway at the moment for makeup. So I found this, which I kind of thought could be quite fun. Oops. So this has been in a few Adorama TV videos. Anyone got any ideas what the videos might have been? I think it's been in 2 Adorama TV videos, which was, and they're both weird. Actually, that's not unusual. And I've also got this. Okay, now I feel pretty good. Freya is now dying behind, like, oh, Dad, you're so embarrassing. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna be here. This is gonna be all right. This is gonna work. This went all the way to New York and it came all the way back again. Go on, Sam, I can see you pressing the button.
So someone said, do you mark the floor to ensure you're in the right place for focus?
No, I don't. That's a good question, though. I don't mark the floor. What I tend to do is sort of stand behind my temporary head and then move it out of the way. And that normally works. Doesn't work every single time. Also, on my floor, if you go to the overhead view, Sam, you'll possibly, maybe be able to see. I've got lines, which are the old decking from my house, which we put down. And that gives us a pretty good idea. So, yeah,
Just to say, we don't have decking in the house. We have
Garden. No, in the garden. Yeah.
So a couple of people have guessed Roger as the knight and Daniel the Viking.
See, I thought Roger they'd probably remember, but Daniel, Norton, manfully stood up and became my model when I did a live stream in New York for Adorama, which was great. And we took all the stuff out there, thinking, of course, in New York, you can't buy anything. They don't have any shops in New York, do they? And I think between the airport and the hotel, I think I saw everything that I had in my suitcase in a store somewhere. Ridiculous, never mind. Okay, so this is merrily chugging away. Let's get on and take the photos, because this isn't going to work first time round. Of course it's not going to. Let's get in here. And there's a ball of light right above my head. this is joking. Come on. Oh. All the smoke's gone up. That's not too bad, except I look really happy. I am a happy... Am I a Viking? Am I something from some fantasy thing? Where's this around? Maybe. Okay, so let's go. Ah, okay. A bizarre kind of, what's going on? Oh, a lot of smoke. Now, the thing about smoke is the background lights are going to vary depending on the density of the smoke. You never really know what you're going to get. It always is a bit of a mystery with smoke, which is both part of its attraction and a major part of its problems. Okay, let's go again. And I can't predict it either, because I've got a 12-second self-timer, so if I set the smoke correct now, by the time the self-timer's counted down, anything's changed. All right. Ah! Okay. Sam said I had to growl. Hey! How's that look? Does it still look like I'm smiling, though? I think it still looks like I'm smiling. So now, Sam, this would be a really good time to tell me that no one's watching, because... you know.
Yeah, there's quite a few people.
Honestly, every photographer should do this. Every photographer that works with models and expects them to do daft things should put themselves in that position so they can experience it. Okay, here we go. That's more of a growl. Too much smoke in front. See, as the
really,
smoke comes
really
in front,
smoky, yeah.
It's you lose the model.
Now, can you just let people know what camera you're using, please?
I could. I don't think I've mentioned the camera. So for those that don't know, I'm an ambassador for Olympus here in the UK. So I'm using an Olympus camera. I'm using the Olympus OMD EM1 Mark III, the newest of their cameras that have come out. And it's a lovely camera. It does a great job. I'm also using the 12 to 40 millimeter lens for the other rest of the technical spec. Oh, and I forgot. There's me saying lens. Okay. We're going to have a couple more of this and then we are done. I'm going to pick the least worst because we've got to set fire to something. Okay, I'm going to do one surprised. That's not too bad. That's not so bad. Getting better. Oh. No capes. Capes are dangerous. Right. Okay. Okay, surprise. Oh. Look at this. Okay. No?
No, do another one. Bit more aggression.
Bit more aggression?
Yeah.
Okay, last one. Bit more aggression. Okay. Oh, 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 hello. Cape in the way. Okay. Okay. Ah! That was quite aggressive.
Oh, that's better.
Okay.
Yeah, that looks better.
You like that one? Let's check it's in focus. Yeah. It's... Yeah, it's in focus, I think. That'll do. That's... Oh, it's really hot. I'm absolutely sweating buckets now. Right, let's get that off. Let's get that off.
So perhaps you can answer a few questions.
Yeah, you go fire some questions as I set up the next bit.
Should you cover the light stand with a cover or flag to keep from seeing the stand?
Yeah, that is a really good question. I did consider that because you can see the light stand. It's not too difficult to clone out, famous last words. So that's my plan. I'm going to clone it out. But a black cloth, matte black cloth, if it's shiny black cloth, you're back in the same situation again. So if you have the right sort of fabric, a duvetine, then that is a good thing to use. I've got one, but it's covering up the window, so all the light doesn't come in through the window. So, yeah. But yeah, good point. Okay, let's move all these out of the way. And we'll get rid of the head and stick. Thank you very much. Uh-huh. Right. Okay, so everything out of the way. Right. Okay, so now we get to the fun bit where we get to set fire to things. Not just things, we get fire.
Just pointing out that's actually my job usually.
It is your job.
I'm kind of locked in behind a desk here, so I'm very jealous that he's gonna set fire to something.
Right. So I've got some of this. So I have a little plastic bag. Which camera? That camera? That back camera. Okay. So that is a little bag of small pieces of paper. I don't think it came like that. I think Sam, you did something to this, didn't you? You cut it up?
Yeah, I just cut it up.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Making it sound a lot more sinister.
This stuff's it's great for us. Should we set fire to a bit? Okay. So this is fire. It is no other word for to describe it, but it is magician's flash paper. So you pop it in there. Whee! Just in case you missed it, let's set fire to another bit. Whoa, blimey. That bit went way faster than the other bit. This is sparkly flash paper. So in the little bag, it shed a load of its sort of iron filings. So it adds some nice little sparks, which is kind of nice. I like that. So that's what we're going to use. I'm going to photograph that. So I'm going to set this up to photograph the flames. Again, if you're watching this live, welcome along to the live feed. Thank you for joining me this afternoon. If you're thinking this is really terrible compared to the videos in Adorama, yeah, that's because we actually edit those where this one is live. Unless you're watching the recording. If you're watching the recording, I guess it isn't live, but you can still pop your questions in. We'll get to them. Okay, so let's have a close-up camera. Let's go. There you go. So we can see what we've got here. So I've just rolled it up into a little bit of a tube. I'm going to clamp it ever so gently into a little metal clamp. And I'm going to photograph that. This is not ideal, but it'll do. It's not ideal because I'm going to have part of the clamp in the shot, but we'll be okay. I'm also going to manually focus because I don't trust the camera to... the camera's autofocus is so good, I know from experience it'll try and track little bits of sparks coming off. So I'm not going to let the camera do its thing. I'm also not going to go for a 12-second self-timer. That would be a very bad idea. It won't be there in 12 seconds. I'm actually going to take loads of photos. So this camera could do 60 frames per second at full RAW and photograph that in this setup. 60 frames a second is nuts. I'm going to limit it to about 8. I think that's probably more than enough. I'm going to dial in some settings. I'm in manual mode. I'm going to go for maybe, turn my trigger off. Let's go for 2,000th of a second, ISO 200 f4. I don't know if that's the right exposure, but I'm going to have a stab in the dark and guess that it is. Okay. Right, here we go. Job number one, set fire to this. Press the shutter. Ready? That was exciting, wasn't it? Okay. Oh yeah, I should probably show you on the laptop. Head over to my laptop. Here we go. So they're a bit blurry, not because they're blurry, just because they are importing in. Yeah, I think I've got the exposure right. I'm happy with that. Oop, I see I'm going that way. Come on, back to the beginning. I seem to have jumped right back to the beginning. That's not quite part of the plan. Here we go. Right. So it changes all the time. So I've got lots of different ones. I could probably do with a bit more headroom in this one. So let's have another go. Let's go again. I'm going to change how I put the paper in as well. So rather than rolling it up, I'm just going to leave it flat. And we'll put that into there just to see if it changes it. And maybe just give myself a little bit more headroom this time. Check I'm still on manual focus. Again, if you've got any questions about, well, other than why are you setting fire to paper? That's a good question.
When you were photographing yourself,
yes.
Could you set the camera to interval timer with a 3-second gap and take 5 in a row?
Yeah, I could have done that, actually. That's not a bad idea. No, you definitely can't do that. Damn. Yeah, that's a good idea.
And someone asked, do you prefer the Micro Four Thirds to full frame?
Well, I'm an ambassador for Olympus. I mean, that probably answers it. So I've had full frame, I've had APS-C, I've had medium format back when I used to do film. I've had Micro Four Thirds. So I've used all of the formats. Yes, I'm getting old. I don't want to carry heavy equipment around. For what I'm shooting, the Micro Four Thirds system is perfect, but this isn't. Join me on Friday. Come over to Olympus's page and ask that question there. But yeah, I could use anything. I don't use this because they're paying me. I use it because I like it. Oh, here we go. Ooh, oh, wow. That was spectacular. We may have to do one more because half of that went on the floor. I should say there is a fire extinguisher just over there. Behind Freya is a fire extinguisher, just in case this goes wrong. no, it's by the door. You'll be fine. Trust me, if it goes wrong, I will be the first over there to get it. Okay, we'll do one more because I'm having too much fun setting fire to things. I can see why you like this now, Sam.
Yeah, it is. It's good fun, and every time you do it, the patterns are different, and the sparkle bits in it are different.
This is a big bit. This is a generous-sized proportion of. Maybe I should go wider. Okay. So we've done this a few times in various different things. We did it at Wellshot. I don't know if any of you managed to stick around, but we did this at Wellshot with Olympus, which was crazy. But yeah, great fun. Okay, here we go. Whoa! I really should have put my head that close. Okay. So and they're coming in. Okay. The only trouble with taking lots of photos is they all have to travel down a USB connection into my, not the world's fastest, wow, look at that one. Not the world's fastest laptop. Okay, I could do this all afternoon, but I probably should stop. I mean, wow, it's like a mini explosion. My head was a bit too close to some of those. Okay, so that's fine. So that's given me the fire shots, and that's given me the picture with me in it. Now I need to bring the two together. I'm just gonna shift one of the cameras around so you can see what's going on. Let's pop that one over there a bit. Okay, and I'm going to put the fire paper well away from the lighter because safety first. Right, okay, so let's go do a little bit of Photoshop work. So we need to choose a few things. We've got lots of fire photos, that's for sure. I need to choose the best of the worst of the pictures of me. Okay, so honestly, no, look, I'm having my teeth done. That's...
Avion is still...
Avion's still here?
He's asked, are you shooting in Pro Capture now?
Avion, hi Avion. So am I shooting in Pro Capture? No. So Pro Capture, the thing about Pro Capture is it's an Olympus thing. It's like predictive shooting. It keeps taking pictures when you half press the shutter. That's great if you don't know when something's going to happen. But if you know when something's going to happen, then you don't need to use that facility at all because it's not unpredictable. So Pro Capture is great when you're doing wildlife and you're doing sports because you don't know exactly when the critical moment's happening. In this case, it only lasts a second. I know when it's going to happen. It's going to last about a second. They are all awful. Right, okay. Let's go.
Another question was, where can I get this paper? What is the name of it? But obviously I can answer that one.
You go with that
it's
one.
It's flash paper. And you can get it from a magic shop. And it comes in paper form. It comes in string, comes in cotton wool, comes in notes like money notes and playing cards and all sorts of things.
Yeah, it's quite an expensive way of setting fire to money. It's probably cost you more than actually setting fire to the money. Okay, so let's see if we can get that to be a little more fiery. There we go. That's the sort of colour we're after. Okay, so we've got this sort of flame yellow that's appearing on me. I might just pop a little bit of a vignette in here as well. and fiddle around with the edges a little bit. I don't want to do too much post-processing because it's the photography that I'm really enjoying. Okay, something like that. Yeah, that's pretty good. One of the lovely things, so why do I like micro four thirds over full frame? Well, I'd like a little bit more room at the bottom, but I haven't got it in my shot, except I have, because micro four thirds has bonus top and bottom of the frame. So that has been one of the most useful things. But as I say, this isn't about micro four thirds, this is about taking some photos. So maybe we'll just crop it in a little bit. I'm not sure I need the top of my helmet. I might just take that away. Yeah, there we go. I can always bring it back in later, but I can't, maybe I'll leave, oh God. Indecisive. If you're not sure, leave it in and bring it back out later on. Right, okay, done. Let's open that image. Bit of clarity, bit of noise reduction. Somebody will ask if I don't do noise reduction. Okay, so I'm gonna be into the editing. So if you've got any questions about the editing, stick them in. If you've got any questions, if you're still watching the live, if you're, got any questions about the photography, do put them in. It's all fine, no bad questions.
Someone's asked, what white balance do you use for the fire?
Oh, that's a good question. The white balance, well, let's have a little look, actually. That's a really good question. Let's go pick a few fire images. So I'm gonna go and pick some images of fire. Quite like that one, that little sort of S shape, maybe those. How many is that? I don't wanna overload my little laptop. That's probably plenty. I can tell you what white balance it was, because I didn't change it. I probably should have done. It was 4000K. That's not the right white balance for fire. It really isn't. That's way too cold white balance. If you want to actually neutralize, I say that, it may actually be fairly close. If you want to neutralize it, then you've got to adjust it for fire, but fire is not the same color. It depends what you're burning. So you can't really give a stock answer for fire. In this case, I'm going with the if it looks right, it is right approach. That's my theory. If it looks right, it is right. Let's pop some clarity, some texture in there.
What tethering software do you use? Is it Olympus specific?
It is, because I'm using an Olympus camera. So I'm using Olympus Capture to connect my camera to my laptop, and then I'm using Olympus Workspace to display the photos. I've got Capture One. I'm just sort of dabbling with it a bit, so Workspace might get replaced by Capture One soon. In fact, Camera Raw might get replaced by Capture One, because it definitely is better for the Olympus RAW files I've been discovering. When I get back to taking actual portraits of not me, then I think I'm going to dive into that much deeper. But I can't lose Photoshop. I need Photoshop for this sort of stuff.
And another question, when using manual focus, what do you prefer peaking from, viewfinder or monitor?
Viewfinder. I don't really use the monitor for that sort of work. And then for manual focus, I actually use magnify. So I turn on the ability to magnify in everything into a little bit larger. It just helps with the manual focusing. Okay, so I'm gonna load my images into a stack, add in the open files, and one of them I won't actually need to. This is where my poor little tablet laptop really starts waving a little white flag, because we now have six raw files, which we want to load in together. Okay, let's pop that one down to the bottom. And I'm gonna close everything else down just to save my poor little tablet. Oh, did I just shut down? No, I didn't, that's okay. I had a horrible feeling I shut down the one I want to keep. Okay. So this is where a bit of time could probably yield a better result, but I'm aware that A, we started 10 minutes later than planned, and B, this is not the most exciting bit because I enjoy the photography bit. So I'm gonna do this relatively quickly. I'm gonna get my fire images, merge them together by changing the blending mode to lighten, and then that's gonna allow me to position my fire wherever I want it to go. So we can pop the fire over there like that. That looks pretty good. Maybe a little bit big, so we can use a bit of free transform just to shrink this down slightly. Hey, look at that, that's okay. So we've got lots of fire going on here, we've got lots of sort of flash stuff. There's a little hot spot in the middle. If I can work out which one of these it is, I can probably just mask that away. It's always the last one, isn't it? Oh no, of course it's not. It's that. What a fool, yes, of course. I nearly forgot. What's that hot spot? But the flash. So we need to get rid of the flash. Let's grab something like the patch tool. Let's try that first. I'll just try patching that away. And make sure we have sampling layers on. I do, that's pretty good. And then we're going to use something like the healing brush. And I'll just heal any other bits away like that. So somebody asked me earlier, would it have been easier to put a black cloth on there? Yeah, I wouldn't have had to do this bit, but you know, it works. Okay.
Got another question.
Yeah, far away.
Are you still losing subscribers doing these fantastic videos?
I'm pretty sure I'm losing subscribers. Yeah, so we tend to lose about 70 subscribers a day, a stream. Unfortunately, a few more have come along to replace those, but I'm not here for subscriber numbers. I've just been there, done that. It's no fun chasing subscribers. It's more fun having fun. Yeah, and watching some of the interesting comments that come along. They're fascinating. Okay, so something like that. We're getting pretty close, I reckon. I think I need to tweak the color on my face. So let's do that. Let's take that file back into, in fact, I'll take a whole thing. Let's just flatten it all down. And we'll take the whole thing into Camera Raw. Camera Raw filter. And I'm just gonna make that a little less yellow. So I think for a little less yellow, I probably would want to add in a little bit more magenta. Yeah, okay, so let's get an adjustment brush and we'll just dial in nothing but magenta white balance and we'll just add in that kind of warmer tone into my face. There you go. Now it looks like I have the fire actually there in front of me, which is much better. Okay, that's working out better than I was worried it was going to. Which is pretty good. And I'm going to finish this off, so I'm going to do one more thing. So if you've got any last questions, now's the time to get them in because we are just 2 minutes away from finishing. Because what I want to do with this is just create the feeling of more of a winter feel. So I've gone with this blue nighttime. I've got the hot fire. I want to add some cold into this as well. So I'm going to add some cold in by applying a bit of snow. So what I've got is my instant snow action. So here, I've loaded it up already, instant snow, available from a website. Sam, what website could they find this instant snow action?
Oh, I think that may be gavtrain.com.
It is gavtrain.com, that's right. So I've got a couple of different snow actions on there. This is the one I did a couple of years ago, the version 2. And the version 2 has different intensities of snow, from blizzard through to first flakes. I'm going to go with light snow, I think, this afternoon.
I do have a question.
Fire away.
Is Affinity software any good instead of Lightroom, as they are objecting to the monthly subscription?
I can understand that. Affinity instead of Lightroom, probably not. No, Affinity instead of Photoshop, yeah, that's more of a match. Affinity instead of Lightroom, you've got a whole bunch of different options. I'd have a look at Capture One as an option. There's a few different ones, but no, Affinity is more of a Photoshop replacement. Here we go. So this on my desktop that you're watching because I'm live streaming from my more powerful desktop is a very quick action to apply. This on my laptop and my tablet, yeah, it takes a bit longer than I realized. But that's okay. That works really nicely. That gives us a nice little bit of snow effect going on there.
Just have another question flakes. Anyway.
Yeah, go for it.
Do you use color lookup tables in Photoshop CC?
I do. Do I use color lookup tables? I do. Color LUTs can be really nice. We'll stick one on in a second and see how it looks. Let's just remove the snow from my face. Just by painting black on there, we'll do that. There you go. So yeah, you can do a color lookup table here on layers, pop it up the top. I like to do them as adjustment layers where I can. And we can come in here and I realize I now have my wrong glasses on, which is, there it is, color lookup table. And you can come and apply various different effects directly in here. So for example, there should be one, Foggy Night. Ooh, not that one. Tension Green. Ooh, that's kind of fun. Tension Green looks quite nice. So let's just reduce the opacity of Tension Green. Yay, look at that. That's okay, isn't it? Hey, good call. I like that.
That was Kirsty.
Kirsty. Thank you, Kirsty. Got my back. Yeah, there we go. On my laptop, that looks great. On yours, oh, it has changed to that tool. Awesome. There we go. Any other questions? Because that seems like a brilliant place to stop. Okay. So there you go. That brings me to the end of my little live stream. If you managed to make it right from the beginning where we didn't live stream, well done. Thank you for that. If you've managed to make it through, brilliant. I really appreciate it. This is another one of our efforts to test something different. Other than user error at our end, hopefully it went okay. I shall review everything afterwards, but if you've enjoyed this, let me know because I enjoy doing these. We're going to be doing another one Friday, 2 p.m. Olympus UK Facebook page. I'll be taking over that where we're going to be doing some less dangerous stuff with coloured pencils, but really quite good fun. I'm looking forward to that one. So Sam and I will be there for that one. All I left to do then is just say thank you very much for watching and keep safe, keep shooting. I'm Gavin Hoey. Thanks for watching.